Hey everyone, welcome to Boardgame Heaven. Today I'm going to do an unboxing of Arcadia Quest Inferno by Cool Mini or Not, along with two extra boxes, one of them is an expansion called Whole Lotta Lava, you can get this at retail. And the other one is the Kickstarter Exclusive box, the Hell of a Box, which you got with the Kickstarter. You won't find that at retail, sadly, but I'm going to unbox it so you can see what's inside. And these two are available at retail this year. So let's quickly have a look at what's inside.
Arcadia Quest Inferno. Let's have a look. Firstly, of course, the back of the box, which, as always, shows the contents, some of the minis, some art, some text, the components. Okay, let's cut it open. All right. A heavy box, which we will see is because it's filled to the brim with goodness. So first, of course, the rule book with the nice art on the front and a summary on the back. And it has some backstory about the Inferno. Some pictures of what's in the box, the game overview, rules, setup. Everything's in here, line of sight, the monsters, a whole lot of stuff, and some story about the heroes and the monsters in the game. Pretty neat. Then there's a campaign book, if you want to play the campaign version of the game. Also very nice, lots of pages. So enough content to play through. Then we have these cards here, these hero boards, and each player can play with its own guild or faction. So there's this one with the snake, one with a lion, one with a raven, and one with a shark. And the original Arcadia Quest also had four different factions, so with this you could have eight different to choose from. Now, some punch boards, very nice looking art, and you know, the hearts and the doors, tombstones, all these cool tokens. It actually has some art on the back as well. So that's very nice, and it's nice and thick. It's about 2 millimeters, I think. More tokens, all these coins. So, double-sided. And a third punch board with lots and lots of tokens. These cool skulls here, and these icons from each of the guilds. More of these demon and heart tokens, and they're also double-sided. So that three punch boards, and there is a campaign sheet, so you can keep track of where you are during the campaign. You can cross things off and fill it in, which is very nice, and there's plenty of them. So, you know, and there's something on the back as well, your inventory. So that's very handy. Let me see. First, there's some cards. There are quite a big pack of cards with items. Let me just quickly open that. Okay. Let's see what you get. Just put that down. I'll just grab a few. So these are all weapons. Grim Bolt, it's a ranged attack, Life Bound, Fancy Blade, a Katar, Hellborn Hammer. Well, plenty of cool stuff and spells and items, artifacts, a whole lot of them at different levels, I see. So this is starter stuff that you start out with, level 1 equipment and level 2 equipment. Let's see how far that goes. And there's more, level 2, level 3, level 4 even. Cool, level 5. Goes on and on. So up to level 5. And then there's rewards. Let's have a separate look at those. Okay. So these are apparently special rewards that you can get, which are very nice looking. You know, these plates, special items that are supposedly very strong. Rewards. This is a death curse. So that's these. So there's apparently curses in this game. Lots of cards to give you no curse. These are damned, system shock, sinful, amnesia, severe nosebleed, paranoia, eternally damned. These are all curses. And then there's something else. Minion on the prowl. Villain on the prowl, guilty conscience, hidden stash, touched by an angel. So, events, probably. And they all have this cool demon head on the back. So that's those cards. Then we have these. So these are the guild cards. Let me just see what that entails. Okay, so we have the Kill Tiger Guild Hero. It's a card used for a PvP quest. And the serpents, the sharks, and the crows also have these. And there's a PvE quest. Are all of these PvE quests? Yep. Okay. So different quests. Enter the gates, kill Cerberus, destroy the tickets. Plenty of quests to do if you're playing PvE, which is also an option in this game. Very nice, big cards. And there's another pack of cards. And I think these are the monster cards that tell you what they can do. Okay. So these are different ones. Oh, we have lots of different colors here. So let's just see what they are. So these are minions, and like in the original game, there's 4 levels. Well, basically this is level 1, this is 2 and 3, 4 and 5 and 6, with a different background color and different stats as they grow stronger. So you've got one for the Harpy, for the Demoness, for Cerberus, the Demon Pitcher, Belial, Belial, funny, the Judge, and the Underlord. Then there's another one here, Benjamin, another villain, Angel Eyes, Leah, they're all angels, or fallen angels maybe, I know. The Wanderer, Justicar, well, that seems to be all of those, these monster cards. Then we have, I'm thinking the player, the hero cards. So all the minis and the models in the game have these cards. Very colorful. Very nice. Plenty of them. Trendier. Some of these are, you know, like nods towards popular culture characters from books or films. You'll recognize some. So here's these guys that we've seen as villains as well, but you can also play them, it seems, as heroes. That's pretty nice. So those are the hero cards. Let's see, then we've got some dice. Standard black and white dice with all these icons on them. Swords, even for melee and ranged attack. So, okay, plenty of those. Let's just put this back for a sec. There is a big miniature in here. A big demon boss on a throne. So let's see how it opens. That just clips in here on the sides, so it's safe to take out of the box. Oh, and there's even some tape here. Okay, let me just cut that off first. And some on this side as well. There, I hope that did it. Yep. Wow. Huge, huge demon on his throne. Very cool. Lots of detail here. You see all the skulls. Let me see if it focuses. Yeah, look at that. Skulls and bones worked into his throne. This is an evil mother. He's got three eyes. Very nice figure. So that's in there. Okay, let's see what else we got. Let's start with this box. Oh, one of these guys is loose in here. What happened? Girl with a crossbow. Oh, I see, she's supposed to be in that slot down there. Well, let me just put this down first. You've got your color bases and the colors of the four different guilds. So you can pick your three heroes and clip these bases on them, indicating that they belong to your guild, to make it easy to tell who's who. And the top tray here has these five little guys, the jester, the dark elf, the swords, the witch, this guy here with the potion, some kind of alchemist maybe, this warrior with his sword, his wavy hair. Very cool miniatures. So that's those five, and she obviously belongs in here. Got shaken up a bit. So there's four more heroes in here. And the Belial, Belial demon with his big belly and his large grin. Very cool. Look at him, how big he is. Awesome. Yep. So nine of those heroes in all, in total. And this has plenty more. So let's have a look at these. All the monsters. If I can get it to slide out. Yes. Wow. Big. Big box of minis. Let's start with the top tray. Okay, there's two more heroes in here. So these, this gladiator looking dude and Thrandir. And there's this Cerberus three-headed hell dog. Two of them. And here's another fat demon. Was this the Belial guy? I'm not sure now. They all have bellies, it seems. There's a lot of these demon minions in here. Nicely detailed. Very cool with the wings. Wow. I mean, that's just... These are awesome. It's funny little chibi minions. And this big, mean-looking demon here. Which has a ball of fire that he's gonna throw at you. So yeah, plenty of minis, and they're, you know, all of these together. They're not light. There's so many in here. It's you know, it's rather heavy. The entire box weighs a ton. So we've got some more stuff in here. These are indentations to accommodate for the bigger models in the top tray. And we've got these guys in the bottom tray. So yeah, five more of these. These are the five angelic ones. And this pudgy guy here with the hammer. Cool. Get a lot of value in these games. And then there's a big pack of tiles. So, and there's a little rip here, so I'm just gonna try and carefully open it here. All right. Let's see what kind of tiles we get and how many. There we go. Okay. So these are all, you know, the same size, of course, as the original Arcadia Quest game, and they have these nine squares on them with inside and outside areas. And you can place the door tokens on them so you know where you can enter. And it has different symbols here, probably to indicate what kind of terrain it is that you're on. And it has the number of the tile down here, so you know when you're looking in the quest book how to put together your map. So it tells you which numbers you need. And on the back, they're all double-sided, is another there's a throne room here and two bits of outside street tiles, all in the cool demonic theme that this standalone set has. So more here with a jail and some storage rooms. A third tile with a little tavern. What looks to be a wharf or something. And here is more street tiles. Yep. Nice, very colorful art. A fifth tile. Number six. Very cool. You can make huge maps with these. So there's nine in all, so you can make a 3x3 grid if you use all the tiles. Oh, look at the huge statue of a demon here in the town square. And another tavern. And here's a completely open space, open square, no buildings. Yep, and another small room or a prison perhaps. With these cool demons in the tiles. So that's pretty neat, so yeah. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, exactly. All right, so that's it. That's everything that there is to be had in the base game. Let's move on to the expansion. So this is an expansion for Arcadia Quest, or Arcadia Quest Inferno, specifically. And it's called Whole Lotta Lava. And it is centered around this fire golem called Ignis. Here he is. And a fallen angel that you need to rescue lest he becomes consumed by the Inferno and turns into a mighty adversary. And there's two of these Hellcats as well that have many lives and keep on coming back into the game. So this expansion adds two new scenarios to play. So let's have a look at what is inside. Okay, so the scenario book which is just a thin booklet and talks about the monsters and the fallen angel, the component, and the two scenarios here: how deep is your lava, and in the name of lava. So all these campaigns, and of course the title of the box itself is all a reference to well-known pop songs. So there's the two PvE cards. Let's have a look. Oh, it's three. So you get a PvE quest here: get the lava lamps, stop the eruption, and kill Ignis. So yeah, three of those. Then there's, of course, the monster cards. Let's have a look. Sticky. Okay, so there is the Hellcat in its four level cards. And Ignis, of course. I love you. There's a lot of humor in Arcadia Quest, so I really enjoy that. And the Fallen Angel. And you can also use the Fallen Angel for as a hero if you manage to rescue him. So that's also included. And some more reward cards, because this scenario can reward you with some new powerful items. So there's a big hammer, Ignis's hammer hand, and a lava whip. So that's pretty cool. And then of course the miniatures. It's probably, yep, tape here, so let me just get rid of that. Oh, there's actually no tape over here. The last one. Okay. There you go. So let's first have a look at this Fallen Angel. It's in the same color as the angels in the main game. You know, this grumpy look on his face. Nicely detailed. It's big wings. So the Fallen Angel and two of these cool Hellcats. Big armored cats, tigers, and Ignis. Oh, my insert seems to be damaged, but that's okay. As long as the minis are okay. So there's a big stone lava golem with his huge hammer hand. Very nice. Another big heavy miniature to add to your game. That was the expansion. Let's move on to the Hell of a Box. Okay, so this is the Kickstarter exclusive Hell of a Box, which held all the extra characters that you got as stretch goals. And you will see that it has a lot of popular culture references in here. I mean, to start, in the base game of Arcadia Quest Inferno, you had the Dark Elf wielding two scimitars, which is very reminiscent of Driss the Urden. And we've got a Driss here, which is a female Dark Elf with a bow. And Driss also wielded a bow, Heartseeker, or Tolmaril in the books. So they just made a female character to go with the male character and gave one the scimitars and one the bow, which I think is pretty cool. And there is this guy called Raven, who looks a lot like a crow from Game of Thrones. Don't know if he's supposed to be a specific one. He kind of looks like one of the eldest boy from the Stark family. I forgot his name. And then here is a Lord Tyron, who is a red-bearded dwarf with an axe and a crown. So that could be King Brenner from the Driss novels. There's Annika here, who doesn't remind me of anything right now, but maybe she does. Somebody else, so just comment below if you think she's supposed to be somebody. And here as well, Johnny. He does look familiar, but I can't remember what right now. Here is Saria, another female hero. Sir Bryce, big armored guy. Megu, sort of like a cat on a broomstick. There's this small guy, Gabriel, who looks like Willow to me from the classic movie. King David III. Annabelle wielding a big sword or scimitar or whatever. There's Rivet, who looks like an Aztec golem of sorts. There's Julie, which is an elf holding a crystal, which reminds me of what was her name? Kira, I think, from The Dark Crystal. And she's even wielding a crystal, so yeah. Here is Lucas, who looks like Atreides from Neverending Story, because he has that symbol around his neck too. Here's Master Pym, who looks like a satyr, like Pan, and also reminiscent because he has the umbrella from the guy from The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe, the Narnia movies. Here is a witch called Wanda. Here's Tigris, who is obviously Leonidas from the 300 movie, from the Spartans. Here's Tao, who looks like some Buddhist monk or something from Dragon Ball Z, I suppose, I'm not sure. This guy, we all know, this is Kragor, who is definitely a nod to the Masters of the Universe villain Skeletor. There's Helen, who looks a lot like from the Disney movie Maleficent. Mercury, who is a female winged demon, like the guys we had in the base game that were the male version. There is Brittany, a female demon. Vexia as a hero. Papa Rook, who looks like this Baron Samadhi voodoo guy. And then there is Tyndall, Tyrek, and Thornwood, who are very much like from the characters from the movie Hellboy 2, the Golden Army, that had this king with this thorn crown and a son and a daughter, the Prince Nuada and Princess Nuala. And they have a different skin tone because in the movie they were completely white, but they do look a lot like them. She even has this shard of the crown that's in the movie. And there's two guys here, a Demoness Captain and a Demon Captain, who look like the Demon faction from Chaos Ball, which is another game by Cool Mini or Not. And these two pets over here, Biru and Scrag, are also in Chaos Ball. So I'm guessing those four are just kind of a crossover. And these are all extra pets that go with the Pets expansion. So we've got a little skeleton here. We've got Gadget, who is obviously the Gremlin Gizmo. And there's Nixon, a badger. And instead of an owl bear, we get an owl bunny. That's so cute. Let's open it up. Okay. So we've got a book here. It says The Fall of Arcadia. And it has a campaign sheet. Let's see if it has multiple, no, just this one. So if you want to use that, you're gonna have to copy it if you don't want to write in the book itself. And it might just be available online as a PDF as well, I'm not sure, but usually they take care of those things. And then there's some campaigns that you can play, quests here. Some extra Kickstarter exclusive missions. So that's always nice to have more content. And there's also content for the Pets expansion, if you got that. So that's great to have more missions to play. And look at that. I love dice and I love dice bags, and this is a nice, soft embroidered Arcadia Quest dice bag. This is the first time I've seen one that comes embroidered. I mean, that is top class, fantastic. I love it. It's very soft, and it has this rope so you can close it. And then there's, a lot of tokens here. So you've got your plastic 3D skulls, lots of them. Your plastic 3D demon heads to replace the tokens, I guess, in the base game. Your red little hearts. And these guild tokens of each guild. Very cool. Some more cards, you know, these quests that we saw. So let's open that up. Let's see if that is enough to get it open. Yep. Okay, here we go. So we've got a PvE quest, save the villagers, stop the fire, find the stolen artifacts, talk to an angel, investigate the sisters, ooh, creepy sisters, free the pet masters, secure the golden amulet, consecrate the grounds, a bone to pick, retrieve an ancient tome, and kill the Justicar. So yeah, plenty of extra quests to do. Very good. Now we've got some more dice. Yes, lovely, lovely colored dice. A color for one for each of the factions, and two extra white ones. And then we have more cards here. So for all the extra heroes, of course, that we get in this exclusive box, you need to have the cards as well. So let's check them out. So here's King David III, and they're all the same back. There's Lucas, Annika, Lord Tyron, Annabelle, Tigris, Tau, Driss, Gabriel, Brittany, Thornwood, Johnny, Saria. I love that. Great. I'm gonna paint him up like Skeletor. Julie, Mercury, Tyrek, Tyndall, Master Pym, Vexia, Raven, Helen, Sir Bryce, Megu, Papa Rock, Wanda, Rivet. Sweet. Then you've got your monster cards again. So the Demoness Captain in her four stages. The Demon Captain. Kragor as a villain. Helen as a villain. And then you've got your pets. So a badger pet. Badger, 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 badger. Biru, the mascot, yeah. Bones, Gadget, Scrag, the Owl Bunny, and all these come in level 2 as well, and level 3. So those are the pet cards, and underneath those cards are some nice plastic coins. Awesome. Always better to have these plastic coins than the tokens in the base game. So that's a very nice little extra. And then on to the minis. So let's have a look. Yes. Cool. So in the top tray, we have all of these. Well, we already saw them on the back, but you know, let's just have a quick look here. They're very detailed again. I really like the look of these. And here is your the owl bunny. I mean, that is brilliant. This tiny skeleton here. The mascot. The badger. Gizmo! So yeah, these guys that you can use as villains, these four. And there's another sculpt to play as a hero, so you can even paint them up differently. You can paint one of them as the actual art suggests on the card, and one of them whichever way you like, so that's cool. Here, a little willow over there. Yep, so that's tray one. And in tray two, more of these guys. A second Maleficent or Helen sculpt to play as a hero. Here's your Leonidas lookalike. The Kings and Raven. This one is holding a coin. She's after the riches, the big, cool looking, you know, like a Chaos Warrior or something. Very nice. And this Golem is also pretty cool. Nice. And here the little Crystal Shard Gelfling. So that's them. Let's see what he has on this shield. Actually, I couldn't quite make it out. It seems to be, I don't know, a skull or something with snakes and wings. Still doesn't ring a bell, but feel free to comment. So that's the second tray of models.
So that was the unboxing of Arcadia Quest Inferno. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and see you next time on Board Game Heaven.